us, then it should behave like a black body and also emit things. So that was a big problem that Wittgenstein could not solve. And I think Hawking and Wittgenstein, they have got into arguments on the subject. And well, he came out with the Hawking temperature for black holes, and that basically solved the problem. So the four laws, for some reason the paper starts out with the second law first, that the area of a black hole could represent something like entropy, because the area of a black hole cannot decrease. As it eats up matter or another star, then the area will always increase. So identifying the area of the event horizon as something proportional to entropy. The proportionality constants were later found by Hawking again. Then this is the first law, basically the conservation of energy. Dm is just the internal energy of the black hole. And basically dq is tds kind of, and the rest. So you see here again that the kappa, which is called the surface gravity, is analogous to temperature. So the surface gravity is analogous to temperature, and the this is a general equation for a rotating black hole, so it has rotational energies and things like that for the internal energy. Then the zeroth law, the thermodynamic equilibrium, that the surface gravity is constant over the event horizon. And then the third law, that it is impossible to achieve absolute zero temperature. So these are the same equations with the constants put in. This is the Hawking temperature, and this is the entropy of the black hole. It is the area of the event.